We got a message on Facebook from Ian Clements, and he said, I love that chili eating video. I reckon you guys can't read this story without laughing. So here we go again, guys. So this is an Australian Bricklayer's accident report. So this Bricklayer's accident report, which is apparently printed in a newsletter for the Brickies Union after it come in. And if this is a true story, this bloke is 100% getting a Darwin Award, but it's amazing. So it reads, Dear Sir, I am writing in response to your request for additional information in Block 3 of the accident report form. I put poor planning as the cause of my accident. You asked for a fuller explanation, and so I trust the following details will be sufficient. I'm a bricklayer by trade. On the day of the accident, I was working alone on the roof of a new six-story building. When I completed my work, I found that I had some bricks left over, which, when weighed later, were found to be slightly in excess of 250 kilos. Rather than carry the bricks down by hand, I decided to lower them in a barrel using a pulley, which was attached to the side of the building on the sixth floor. Securing the rope at ground level, I went up to the roof, swung the barrel out, and completely loaded it with bricks. Then I went down to the ground floor and untied the rope, holding it tightly to ensure a slow descent of the bricks. You will note in Block 11 of the accident report form that I weighed 70 kilos. Due to my surprise at being jerked off the ground so suddenly, I lost my presence of mind and forgot to let go of the rope. Needless to say, I proceeded at a rapid rate of knots up the side of the building. In the vicinity of the third floor, I met the barrel, which was now proceeding downwards at an equally impressive speed. This explained the fractured skull, minor abrasions, and the broken collarbone, as listed in Section 3 of the accident report form. Slowed only slightly, I continued my rapid ascent, not stopping until the fingers of my right hand were two knuckles deep into the pulley. Fortunately, by this time, I'd regained some presence of mind and I was able to hold on tightly to the rope in spite of beginning to experience pain because my knuckles were in the pulley. At approximately the same time, however, the barrel of bricks hit the ground and the bottom of the barrel fell out. Now devoid of the weight of bricks, the barrel weighed approximately 20 kg. I refer to you to my weight, 70 kg. As you can imagine, I began a rapid descent down the side of the building.
Six stories.
In the vicinity of the third floor, I met the barrel coming up. This accounts for the two fractured ankles, broken tooth, and several lacerations on my legs and lower body. Here, my luck began to change slightly. The encounter with the barrel seemed to slow me enough to lessen my injuries when I fell into a pile of bricks. Unfortunately, only three vertebrae were cracked. I am sorry to report, however, as I lay there on the pile of bricks in pain, unable to move, I again lost my composure and presence of mind and let go of the rope. And lay there watching the empty barrel begin its journey back down towards me and then eventually on top of me. And this explains the two broken legs. I hope this answers your inquiry.
Oh, that poor darkness, my old friend.
If someone was able to animate that, that's great viewing. Oh, mate, how is that man still alive, Brad? I have absolutely no idea. Oh, Sean's message through. He thinks he can add to that story.
Oh, jeez, here we go.
Appreciate that, mate. Maybe just put a couple of days in between at the head store already. I don't know why we always do this so early in the show. It just buggers me.
Because I like watching you hurt.